Welcome once again to CREA's Ask Me Anything. We have three members of the board of directors with us once again for this episode, including Costa Poulopoulos, Cliff Stevenson, and Jill Oudil. Welcome to all of you. Looking forward to chatting with you again this time around. And let's go right to a question from a CREA member. Costa, why is CREA asking to increase dues?
Great question, Mark. You know, a lot of members have asked that question. The reality of it is, look, we have plan on investing on our three strategic pillars, advocacy, reputation, and realtor.ca with technology. We haven't had a dues increase in 10 years. Right now, the most important thing is that we don't rest on our laurels. We've done so many good works on all three fronts, on advocacy, especially over the last year with the pandemic, but pre-pandemic. We want to make sure that we keep going forward. There's buzz out there about, you know, taxing on capital gains. I mean, we want to have a strong advocacy group and a strong advocacy team to ensure that we advocate for the dream of home ownership for consumers and for our members. So look, same thing on the technology front. I'm sure that Cliff and Jill will touch on that, the strength of realtor.ca. And of course, the strength of our reputation, making sure that consumers have confidence in the realtor brand. So we need to make sure that we stay strong, that we have a strong national association that's representative of all members coast to coast. And look, we're not taking this lightly. We've promised and we've actually achieved a 10% reduction on costs. And we're looking forward to looking at non-dues revenue and cost recovery for some of these benefits. So there's a lot to unwrap there, but that's pretty well one of the, you know, the high level reasons to why we need to look at a strong association, and we need some more funds to get there.
All right, Jill, what would you like to add to this?
I can just say, I mean, Costa really covered the nuts and bolts of it, but realistically costs have increased over the last 10 years, whether it be the level of technology that's just needed to run any company. It's amazing that we haven't had to increase it till now. And I can tell you that the board of directors was very pleased with the way that staff brought this forward and not making a sudden increase for our membership. Given that it's for the next few years is the change, none even this year. So, and as Costa mentioned, the commitment to decrease costs, not just take it from the member, we're going to every necessary way that we can, involving getting money from the outside, as well as an increase to the membership, and then also a commitment to actually decrease costs.
Cliff, some thoughts from you?
Yeah, it's been said really well by both Jill and Costa here. I think that the growing membership numbers over the last 5 years have really sort of hidden that need for us to increase our dues over the last little while. We've been very fortunate as a membership. But, you know, we've been really strategic with this. And to Jill's point, we have talked at length, and so much work has been done. But what I really liked, the part that I really liked about what the staff did for the lead up to this was, you know, we've been talking about this 10% cut and this 10% decrease. It was really a right sizing of our products and services. It wasn't a, you know, a broad axe taken right across the top and taking something off of everything. And I think that, you know, we've been good stewards of our members' dues and our members' fees. We've made smart decisions and good decisions over time. And I think that, you know, taking this money and investing this where we need to invest this to all of Costa's and Jill's points, this is imperative. This is really important for us to do this.
All right. Next question. Jill, what is CREA doing to get leads to members?
Well, ultimately, one of our best resources is the realtor.ca. It's absolutely the best way that we can get leads directly to realtors. And the technology staff at CREA has been amazing. The changes that they continuously make to realtor.ca to get the leads direct with no cost, no extra charge to the realtors, and the quality of leads has improved. Every year, the amount of leads going through realtor.ca, it's all graphed and metrics. We want to see exactly how much is improving. And it continuously does in a marketplace that is more and more difficult to achieve.
Cliff, tell us more about this.
Well, I had the pleasure of sitting on the CREA Technology Committee for 4 years when there really was a shift to partnering with companies to come in and provide more data for the end user, which is the general public. That movement to what does the consumer want to see and what do they want for information at their fingertips, that was a significant shift for us. And to see the growth, I mean, I did a presentation in 2019. I was looking back on my notes a little while ago, and we were very, very proud of the fact that in 2018, we doled out 2.7 million leads to our members. In 2020, that went to 4 million. I mean, that's a significant increase in 2 year time. But that really speaks, you know, as Jill just said, to the technology staff at CREA. They've done amazing work. It speaks to the volunteer members that have volunteered their time on the technology committee. But again, you know, getting some very, very interesting and specific information, whether that be with companies like Local Logic or, you know, a total cost of living measurement at a granular level by property. I mean, this is all information at the consumer's fingertips, helping them make better decisions for the real estate needs.
All right, Costa, some thoughts from you?
Yeah, listen, Cliff, really, and Jill were kind of captured all of this. I'm just going to add a couple of things to that. So really, I guess it's to keep realtor.ca relevant. And what I mean by that is, look, we're the most preeminent site and for Canadian real estate. Anybody looking for real estate goes to realtor.ca. We have to continue being relevant. We have to make sure the data integrity, data accuracy is there, basically giving consumers trust in the system, which we have done. So we need to continue to do this. There's a direct correlation between traffic to realtor.ca and leads that come out of that. So I know that last year during the pandemic, traffic to realtor.ca doubled. And not coincidentally, the correlation is that leads last year during the pandemic doubled from the previous year. So there is a correlation. So we need to have more eyeballs, more people coming, trusting in the website, trusting in the accuracy. And that, you know, along with the DDF partners that we have, the TD Bank, Kijiji, Scotiabank, the Globe and Mail, these are all trusted partners through DDF where consumers go on their site and then get right back to realtor.ca. And again, more traffic, more leads. And so all of that kind of plays into it. So we got to make sure that we keep realtor.ca relevant.
Great. All right. Our next question is also about realtor.ca. Cliff, what's the plan for realtor.ca to compete with some of the large private sector companies that are coming into the Canadian real estate market?
Yeah, I touched on this in my previous answer. I think it really is about understanding consumer behavior, wants, and needs. I mean, this is the end user of our platform. And I think in our past, I'm going back quite a ways, we had a mentality that it was our site, our data, our information, and we're going to provide the consumer what we think that they want to see. That's completely changed now. We really are hypersensitive to feedback from the public, how we can change our site, how we can better our site. But then again, it's that partnering with the experts in their field, companies that can provide extra layers of data so that, you know, there once was a time on realtor.ca where, you know, the consumer would have 7 different browser tabs open because that's the amount of information they had to sort of add to just the basic listing information. Well, realtor.ca is completely changing now. Now, with respect to your question specifically and competing with other portals, I think if we just stay focused on what the consumer is looking for and we worry less about what everybody else is doing, I think we'll be just fine. I mean, we have a tremendous head start here, but Costa mentioned this earlier in an earlier answer. We cannot rest on our laurels. We need to continually invest in this site and we continually need to add as much as we can from a data layer perspective.
Joe, what are your thoughts on how a realtor.ca can stay competitive?
Well, I think it boils down to being innovative. And our staff, there is actually a sector of staff that our CEO has, their sole goal is innovation. So making sure that we stay ahead. I have heard that even staff has done contests with other tech type people to help us innovate from the outside, not just our staff. You have to be creative these days. And I think that the one thing that we have to remember based on the question is, realtor.ca is the only full and complete source of data in Canada. So that's something we will always have above other competitors, which is absolutely crucial. And it's crucial that we have integrity of data, you know, accurate data to provide to the public.
Costa, what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I think both Jill and Cliff touched on this. You know, it's about relevance. provide data that consumers want. We opened up sold data. That is something consumers want. So when we're able to in jurisdictions where it's allowed, we're going to continue to do that. It's provide what consumers want and create that trust. Consumers want information. They want data. We have that data. So as long as they trust in that data. So that's going to continue to put us ahead of the pack with everywhere else. Another thing is the mobile app. I mean, put a tremendous amount of resources in creating the mobile app, the realtor.ca mobile app, because that's what consumers wanted. And just to put it in perspective, 71% of all searches on realtor.ca are from a mobile device. So that's another example of how do we keep it relevant, keep giving consumers what they want to make sure that the stickiness of realtor.ca is there, that it's the go-to site for all things real estate in Canada. So, you know, we need to look back at what we've created. We sometimes forget what we've created. The data distribution facility, the realtor.ca, our MLS system, the reputational part of it, the trademarks, you know, we should pat ourselves on the back. But again, as Cliff said, as we've said, we don't rest on our laurels. We continue to evolve. We continue to improve and give consumers what they want so that the trust is there and that is the go-to site.
All right, last question. Jill, what is CREA doing to increase diversity among its staff and executives?
Well, staff actually does have an action plan going forward. It is top of mind, given the scenario that has been going in the world, not to mention it is top of mind anyhow. Recently, we had all of the CREA staff, as well as all of the board of directors, on a diversity, equity, and inclusion storytelling session. It was very interesting and roundtable discussions, fantastic, because I think education is going to be key and working a plan going forward.
All right, Cliff, your thoughts on this?
Hey, listen, this is a hot topic, and we're not immune here, and we're not on our own here. This is something that's a conversation that's happening in corporate world, and it's happening in boards and associations as well. And I think it's just important for the members to know that we're on it. Like, we're having these conversations, and quite frankly, they're not easy conversations to have. Let's just address that. They're challenging conversations. They're courageous conversations. But CREA is absolutely having these conversations because we realize the importance of this initiative, both at the staff level and the volunteer level. I mean, even when we talk about things like director recruitment committees and talking about diversity in that arena as well, I mean, that's really important. We have a lot of volunteer members across this country that come from a very diverse background, and having representation from, you know, various communities and individuals across the country is critically important to CREA.
Costa, some final thoughts from you.
Yeah, listen, it's such an important area that, you know, we are looking, and we've created a diversity, equity, and inclusion task force or group to make sure, to Jill's point and Cliff's point, that, look, the country is made up of this great mosaic of cultures and diverse perspectives and people, as is our membership. And we want to make sure that we actually reach out to members to bring them into a leadership role, to get diverse perspectives, to bring in this inclusion, because you know what, sometimes people are reluctant to put their name forward. So we want to make sure that everyone has an opportunity and that we welcome these perspectives. And we want to make sure that everybody comes to the table at a leadership level, at a staff level, and it captures ideas and perspectives of consumers that are buying properties in Canada. I mean, there's so much talent throughout our membership, and sometimes they're reluctant to come forward, put their name forward. So we want to make sure that it's, we're in the spirit of an inclusive leadership arena, that those diverse perspectives are brought forward. So we'll seek them out if we have to.
All right. So as we wrap up, Costa, this is your last appearance on Ask Me Anything as the chair of CREA. You're stepping out of that role. Cliff will be taking over. Cliff, did you want to share some thoughts about Costa as he moves on from the chair's role?
Well, Costa's pretty nervous right now about what I'm going to say. I know he is. But in all seriousness, and I'll take off my smartass hat for a second here. We have been so fortunate to have Costa at the helm. And I just think every member out there should hear that and understand that. This was somebody who led the courageous conversations and led our board of directors, the membership as a whole, during a global pandemic. And I've said this before and I'll say it again. Costa was the right guy for the job. 100% of all the people I've had the chance to serve with at the CREA level, especially, Costa was the one to take the reins during this year. So Going to miss him in this capacity anyway. Going to lean on him heavily next year. And I do have big shoes to fill, even though I might have said the opposite earlier on.
Jill, your thoughts?
Well, actually, I was really expecting Cliff to lean more on the smart-ass part. So now I'm confused because he took everything I wanted to say. Costa, though, we do love you. You were the perfect person for this job. Cliff couldn't have said that better. He is so calm. You're so calm, Costa. And actually, for all of those Ask Me Anything viewers out there, he's exactly what you see. He's natural. He's honest, and he's an all-around great person. These Ask Me Anything, interestingly enough, it is not scripted at all. None of us have a script. We're not given notes. We come on here and we say exactly how we feel and what we know and think, which is pretty fun. And so we will miss you so much, Costa, but you are not going anywhere. Don't think that you're getting away without us, because you're not going anywhere for at least a year.
Wow. Thank you, guys. Thank you both. Look, Mark, I just want to say thank you. I got to tell you, it has been a sincere privilege to be part of this team, one of the entire group. So thank you, guys. Beautiful comments. I really appreciate that. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Costa, and good luck to you. Jill, Cliff, we'll see you next time on Ask Me Anything. And to CREA members, thank you for your questions. If you have more, please send them to us. We look forward to responding to your queries on a future episode. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.